Hello, everybody. My name is Christian Chalo. Welcome to your first market report of 2014. Today, we're Wednesday, January 8th. Today, folks, I want to talk to you of a movement that we had in the pharmaceutical sector. Two things happened. First of all, Teva Pharmaceuticals, that you see here on the graph, acquired the company Nupathe. So that created a wave of buyers into the pharmaceutical sector. But also, there was an analyst at J.P Morgan that said that the biotechnology sector is expected to do good in 2014 because a lot of positive clinical results have been made concerning the phase 3 on a lot of drugs. Also, the reimbursement program concerning those drugs is actually pretty interesting. So those companies will continue to actually do good in 2014. So I'm going to show you a list of the many breakouts that we have on that sector that are standing out today, and also a list of the breakouts that are good, yes, technically speaking, but the loss potential is great though. So let's start with the ones that we find are great on marketgurus.tv. So you can have access to marketgurus.tv for free for 10 days just by clicking on the link below. And among our choices that we favor in our analyst choice portfolio is, first of all, Allozin Therapeutics. So a stock like that, yes, it's in a nice technical pattern. Yes, it's clearly breaking out. As a stop loss, us, instead of tolerating a loss until 1362, which is more than 10%, we actually are putting a stop loss around 1440, so it's about a 6% loss, 6-7% loss potential. Alkermes, actually, it's also one that we favor too among our analyst choice portfolio on marketgurus.tv. Actually, our stop loss is around 3960, so not too far away though from the current price, so it's about a 6-7% loss potential on Alkermes. There's also another one that's not that bad. It's Pasteur Pharmaceuticals. It's clearly breaking out, so it's also one that's outstanding on the pharmaceutical sector. Let's not forget also Isis Pharmaceuticals, but what's not interesting with Isis Pharmaceuticals is that it's already taking 7.61%, which is a lot, right? 3843, it's about what? About 7%. Here, it's at 36, it's more than 10%. And until that important resistance, so at 33, it's more than 20% though. So actually, on a stock like that, the risk potential, the loss potential is really too great to be put among our analyst choice portfolio at marketgurus.tv. But technically speaking, it's still a buy. And if you're getting in on a stock like that, you have to put a trailing stop loss of 7%. So in case your stock loses more than 7%, you'll be a portion of your positions will be sold. And maybe your exit point could be, another portion could be put at 36.47 and another portion at 31.48 if you end for the long term on Isis Pharmaceuticals. Mylan Labs, same scenario too. Actually, our 41.11, that's actually our where a stop loss should be on a stock like that. It's clearly breaking out. And 41.33, actually, it's about 7%, so it's not that bad though for 7% as a loss potential. And I think this one too could be one of our favorite, just like PCRX. And Endo Health Solutions, it's actually also clearly breaking out, but the loss potential is around 8%, around $62, so it's too much for Endo Health Solutions. So as I said, same strategy as Isis Pharmaceuticals, put a trailing stop loss of 7% or so, and at 62.46, 62. You'll get out of your positions on Endo Health Solutions. And a stock that is to be watched for an eventual breakout if the momentum continues is Arena Pharmaceuticals. I'm a buyer at $6 on that stock. So this is the list on the acquisitions of Nupathe by Teva Pharmaceuticals. Those two stocks highlighted with an eye represent good opportunities for a buy. Pasteur and Mylan Labs also, but those stocks are, the loss potential is around 7.5%, which is a little bit great, but okay. And Isis Pharmaceuticals and Endo Health Solution, put a trailing stop loss in those stocks because the loss potential is too great, more than 7%. And actually, that's what you should do to actually minimize the risk potential on your buyings on those stocks. So that's it, folks. See you next week for your market report on YouTube.com.